Welcome to the first episode of Superhero School, the place you learn about all the superhero powers, gadgets, and places anybody would want to know. And since we're about to see the release of Dark Phoenix, we thought we'd start with Cyclops' Visor. If you're unfamiliar with Scott, let's get to know him for a second. The longtime leader of the X-Men, his real name is Scott Summers, but we know him by his alias, Cyclops. He stands at about 6'3" and weighs 195 pounds, brown eyes, sometimes glowing red when using those powers, and brown hair. And he was born in Anchorage, Alaska. Cyclops' mutant ability, his optic blast, allows him to project a powerful beam of concussive, ruby-colored force from his eyes. And that's where the visor comes in. Cyclops' visor prevents random discharge and is aligned with a powered ruby quartz crystal. The visor fits around Scott's head, allowing for peripheral vision, and was originally designed by Charles Xavier himself, although Scott Summers did have some input in the design. The visor itself has a rather complex design, effectively built around manipulating the ruby crystals. The lenses can be adjusted so that the variable exit slot is anywhere from 0 to 0.79 inches in height with a constant width of 5.7 inches. The visor itself is full of a low-density foam to provide strength and stability, but not additional weight. The whole device itself is controlled by a power regulator microchip. This is used to control all subsystems and power systems. Each ear cup has a lock and a lock control mechanism, keeping it from falling off of Scott's head. Then there's the firing stud. There's a right-hand stud there and an additional one on this side. They're what people are most familiar with from the movies. They allow Scott to release the optic blast and adjust its intensity. The fast neutron detector actually measures the amount of energy being released by Scott's eyes. And the rack and pinion support and gear system are actually at the heart of the control system for the ruby quartz, controlling all movement of all the lenses. Also part of this system is the motion solenoid. And then at the heart of it all is the ruby quartz plates, which we're going to talk a little bit more about. The rack and pinion system within the visor adjusts each of the ruby quartz panels, allowing Scott a full control over width, distribution, and power intensity. The motion solenoid can adjust the panels to have a setting anywhere from 0 degrees, which is fully open, to 90 degrees, which is fully closed, or anywhere in between. The lower the angle of obstruction, the more intense the beam becomes. A 0 degree setting provides near no obstruction, where 90 degrees provides the standard obstruction required for Scott to see, but not use the intense beam. Without his visor, Scott Summers' blasts are uncontrolled, either being completely shut off by him closing his eyes, or in completely full blast mode, capable of mass destruction. Fans have witnessed on several occasions the massive and undeniable destructive power of Scott's unrestrained eye blasts. You can clearly see why the visor is absolutely necessary. With a visor on, Scott's eye blast becomes a precision weapon, allowing him to adjust the intensity, rapid fire, and take down individual targets with impunity. And despite all the functionality the visor brings, yeah, it looks cool. I hope you liked the first episode of Superhero School. If you like this video, make sure you comment below, ask us some questions about Scott Summers, and maybe your question will be the subject of the next class. If you like this video, make sure you press like below, click subscribe, and if you don't ring that bell, you won't get any updates. Peace.